Jews have lived in Belgium for almost 2,000 years. Antwerp has been called the Jerusalem of the North. Belgium used to be a safe place for Jews. Not so much anymore. Many of the killers in the recent Paris attacks were Belgian Muslim radicals, the kind who are violently anti-Semitic. In a series of interviews conducted before the attack, Belgian Jews told CBN News that life in Belgium was still good, but the possibility of danger was ever present.
The idyllic years are over. The tranquil years are definitely over. It can come. You can go to a grocery, and all of a sudden somebody could shoot you down. You can go to a museum, and the same can happen.
Professor Julien Klenner was a hidden child during the Holocaust, while half of Belgium's Jews were sent to Nazi death camps. Now he must face it all again.
How comes that the Shoah was not able to quiet down people about Jews? Why didn't that disappear into the oblivion of history, like so many other ludicrous approaches? Why is it still there? What have I done to deserve that?
At the heavily protected Jewish Takamoni School in Antwerp, director Jan Maas told us the school's history and how in World War II it was liberated by Allied troops.
So these are all American soldiers, I think, here. The US Army, USA, 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 USA.
We are very grateful to them.
And Maas shared how during part of the Nazi occupation of Belgium, the principal at Takamoni was an SS officer.
And I know from one of the former students, he told me, he got his Star of David here in school. He got it here in school.
Today, the school's students are threatened again by forces in Belgium that want to kill them. Michael Greenberg is the head of Jewish studies at Takamoni.
If we think that it's not enough secure to let them to go outside during the day, we keep all the students here during the day.
Most of them get over the fact that, yes, for most of the activities, you need protection. You need security.
At Beth Kabad Synagogue in Brussels, Rabbi Shimon Lasker said he personally thinks reports of anti-Semitism are overblown. Yet outside, they removed the sign for the synagogue because it kept getting vandalized.
They came in the middle of the prayers, the Jewish security, to announce that when you go home, please be careful. Don't walk too many people together. Don't try to show that Jews are walking on the street. Can you imagine? That's what we have to think about. How to walk on the street.
Today, you have anti-Semitism from the left and the extreme left. Anti-Semitism that is going into a form that's called anti-Zionism. And you have anti-Semitism from the Arab and Muslim communities.
Vivian Teitelbaum, a member of the Brussels Region Parliament, says the government isn't doing enough to stop it.
It's being a problem in schools, it's a problem on the streets, it's a problem with graffitis on the wall, it's a problem of security, it's a problem, it's a problem in many different aspects of our daily lives.
In the Flemish town of Mechelen, the Holocaust Museum has been built next door to a former German army barracks, where Jews were deported to concentration camps. Claude Marinover, vice chairman of the museum and vice mayor of Antwerp, says Belgian Jews today should not have to risk being attacked in the street for looking Jewish.
There is no reason whatsoever that a Jew, religious or not, should walk down a street from a city, big or small, in Belgium with the fear of being attacked because of that. Unacceptable.
Serge Rosen, president of the Jewish Congress in Belgium, is worried about the rise of anti-Semitism, but cautions that it is not like the pre-Nazi period.
When people start to compare the situation of the Jews now with what existed before the war, I don't think that's relevant as a comparison. I think we are well integrated in the societies. The mainstream societies accept us, respect us. The political authorities support us.
But it's a fair question to ask if some Jews are in denial over the danger they face. The same was asked of Jews in Europe during the 1930s, when it was said that the pessimist left for New York. The optimist went to Auschwitz. Even when the trains came for them, some Jews believed they were being taken to a better life and not to certain death. Europe today is not Nazi Germany, but anti-Semitism is worsening. And yet many Jews again choose to hope because they don't want to leave. But with the Muslim migrant surge from the Middle East, even more anti-Semitism is being imported into Europe. Baron Jacques Brochi is a neurosurgeon and Belgian senator.
They import the conflict of the Middle East. And due to that, the message is not a message of living together. It's not a message of love. It's a message of sometimes killing Jews.
For most Jews everywhere, whether to stay or go comes down to the welfare of their children.
And this is where I think today the Jewish community in Brussels, I'm talking about people who were born in Belgium, are starting to ask themselves, is Belgium the place for the future of their children or the future for them to continue living?
And for increasing numbers of Jews, the answer to that question is no.
Security? Look, look, send your kids to a Jewish school here in Brussels, or even in Antwerp. What do you see? Paratroopers? Is that a normal life?
After the recent Paris attack, Zaka, the Israeli emergency response team, held drills with Belgian Jews on how to deal with terror attacks and so-called mass casualty events, a clear sign that some fear the worst.
Belgium has to start fighting so that its Jewish community can stay here, because a democracy that cannot defend its minorities is not a democracy anymore.
Dale Hurd, CBN News, in Brussels and Antwerp, Belgium.